I have created a series of videos about how to love yourself. And the reason why is because I didn't realize it until a couple of years ago that I truly didn't love myself. Some of the signs for me that I didn't truly love myself was because I talked mean to myself. I was very critical to myself. I had a problem with accepting a compliment. I didn't take up for myself. I had a hard time saying no. If you have an issue with some of the things that I just named, you may have a problem with loving yourself. So if you have a problem with loving yourself, make sure to watch this full video and also go back and watch some of my other videos about how to love yourself. Tip number one, find a hobby. One of the main benefits of finding a hobby is that it helps you to relax. It's also good for your mental health and it can lower anxiety, stress. A hobby can even help you cope with depression. If you're not for sure about what your hobby is, then that's when you're gonna have to experiment and just try a couple of things. I have recently found a new hobby. I'm not an outdoors person because I live in the South and almost year round it's very hot here. So I'd rather stay on the inside of the house where it's cool and I can be comfortable. But I recently started helping my husband cut the lawn. The first time I tried it, I actually really liked it and I could tell that it was gonna be something that I was going to do again. And what I like about cutting the lawn is, number one, I'm doing something productive and I'm also exercising at the same time. I am helping my husband out. And you may think, well, that's a man's job to cut the lawn. But if you knew my husband, then you would know why I chose to do something that's going to make his life easier. For example, one thing what I love about him is that he does housework, he cooks, and he's a great provider. Whatever thing that needs to be done around the house, he tries to do it. So one of my main focus of having him with the lawn is that I wanted to do something to help him to where he won't have to work as hard. Once I cut the lawn for the first time, I knew that I would be doing it again. And it was because it's very beneficial for me. And the reason why is it helps me to relax and it makes me tired. So I know that I'm going to get a good sleep at night. It's kind of therapeutic for me. And the reason why is because I get a kick out of just mowing the lawn and staying on the straight line while I'm mowing. And just stand back once I'm done and just see how good the lawn looks. It makes me feel good. Tip number two. Do things that make you happy. Do things that inspire you. Life is short and we only have one life. So it's very important to just to experiment and do some things that you've never done before or try something that you even think that you may not like because you may fall in love with it. We all have something that inspires us. So you have to figure it out what that thing is that inspires you. What inspires me is when I have said something or done something that inspires someone else. And when that person shares it with me, it makes me happy. Tip number three, have fun by yourself. Yes, you can have fun by yourself. What I notice about a lot of women that's not married, they feel like that in order to have fun or in order to be happy, that they have to have a man in their life. And I know you may think, okay, it's easy for you to say it because you're married, but you guys, when I first got married, I wasn't happy with myself. And I can remember once I got married, after a couple months, I still wasn't happy with myself because it was still something missing. And the thing that was missing is that I had to learn how to be happy with myself, how to be happy by myself, to enjoy my own company. So whether you are single or married, that's something very important that you want to learn how to do is enjoy your own company. One of the main reasons why is because you are going to have yourself until you die. So why not enjoy your own company? I have a question for you. Do you have an issue with loving yourself? And if you do, what are your main struggles? If you like my message and you want to support me, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell. That way, every time I upload a video, you will be notified. I have a Facebook group called Chats with Flow, and it's for self-improvement. If you want to learn and grow as an individual, you should join my Facebook group. I would love to have you. Thank you for tuning in, and make sure to stay tuned for the next upload of How to Love Yourself. Bye.